Hi, I'm Samit Rao. In this video series, we will look at fault detection and diagnosis in process and chemical plants. Specifically, I will talk about multivariate analysis techniques like PCA, walk through a MATLAB demo on fault detection and diagnosis, and also we will look at multiple industrial success stories in this application. Before we delve into this topic, it helps to take a step back. Traditionally, chemical engineers have relied on process simulations and first principles modeling to understand their processes. Of late, the advent of large amounts of process data has given rise to techniques in data-driven modeling. These help obtain actionable insights from process data and aid in simulations and engineering studies, such as debottlenecking, increasing product quality, and increasing production. Today, we will touch on a part of the data analytics technologies. All right, so what does advanced data analytics exactly mean in this industry? This 2x2 matrix helps summarize my view of data analytics in this space. Analysis on the first column refers to conventional analysis tools, things that the industry has been doing for quite some time. Even if they don't put it into practice, they are certainly aware of it to a greater extent than machine learning analytics here. This is all the current rage right now. Big data refers to data that satisfies the 3 V's criteria of volume, velocity, and variety. This could be process data, text logs, image data, and so on. Data in this industry refers to conventional, neatly tagged time series data. This industry generates a huge ton of data, but it is mostly used for making reports other than forward-looking analysis, something that I was guilty of in my previous job as well. Each of the squares indicates MathWorks' value proposition in this space. You can use MATLAB for automating your data analytics, performing multivariate analysis on big data, predictive maintenance by using machine learning, and fault detection and image processing using machine learning and big data. In this presentation, today, we will only be looking at multivariate analysis. Process data are often characterized by the presence of large numbers of variables from different sources, something that is generally much more difficult to handle than just large numbers of observations. How do I determine what are the principal variables I need to be looking at? What is their effect on the process? And how can I control these variables so I can consistently achieve a high quality and keep costs low? Latent variable methods like principal component analysis and projection to latent structures are uniquely suited for the analysis and interpretation of process data, because these are methods that exploit the correlations amongst variables in the data sets. Because these methods tell you exactly what variables are the source of issues, you can take very specific action, such as avoid unplanned downtime, improve plant performance through cycle time reduction, reduce waste, root cause investigation of defective batches, and controlling product quality. There have been several success stories using these techniques in industry. Here, I have highlighted a few of them. The first story talks about a batch process for drying an agrochemical material at FMC Corp, a fertilizer company. They used custom MATLAB toolboxes and analyzed the process and isolated the process variables that were responsible for the product quality differences. The second paper is from Pfizer, and the objective was to determine the materials available in inventory that should be combined and the ratios of those that should be blended in order to obtain the best next lot of finished product. In this project at Frito-Lay, an online vibrational sensor was used to develop a soft sensor for real-time prediction of product texture in chips. An accelerometer is used to record the vibrations generated by chips falling onto a metal surface. The blister level and brittleness of the chips are predicted by analyzing various sensor data together using PLS. Another example is from GSK. They spoke at MATLAB Expo 2019. One of their products is Sensodyne, which is a toothpaste. Toothpaste is almost regulated like medicine in some countries. So there is a lot of regulation and quality check, of course. Change and experimentation is quite difficult in the process. You can see some of the challenges they faced here. Batch process quality depends on the experience of the operator. Databases are silos. You need different logons, etc. In this presentation, they spoke about how they use their process data to improve the performance of future batches. If you remember the 2x2 framework from the earlier slide, you can see it is well replicated here. They used univariate statistics, multivariate analysis, and machine learning to get knowledgeable insights from their data. And finally, they also spoke about why they chose MATLAB. You can see multiple different reasons mentioned here, linking different files, rapid prototyping, consulting support on projects, and app building.